Hey folks, Silvius here. I'm back on Leaf. I figured I would go give the Cartophila a little bit better of a try this time around. Oh, jeez. I think I may have started this recording at a slightly poor time. For those who watched my video, my Leaf video, like two videos ago, I did explain a living situation problem that I have. And you'll also note that in that video I had to keep, like, sort of pausing because I didn't want things to be getting picked up by my microphone. It's really hard to tell what else can get picked up by my microphone besides just me. Oh boy, I still don't have a bag of apples. My offers? What am I? Oh, well, I did bid incredibly low, I suppose. Yeah, there we go. Look at that. I'm barely on the first page. Still, 3k I think is a lot less than what I paid the last time around. Let's go with 3-1-1. Create my offers. Kill that one. Alright, we are going to go sell the trophies. Yeah, so anyway, I'm having that issue where I might just need to randomly start talking and rambling so that other things don't get picked up by my microphone. So anyway, yeah, plan is go after the Cartophila, hit the tarantulas on the way. Hopefully by the time I'm done with the Cartophila task a couple of times, I'll just naturally pick up the tarantulas on the way. At least that's the plan. Let me check here. Killing in the name of tarantulas. Yeah, I still have, 292 of them to go. Blood Tusk still needs to be killed. Cartophila, 44. So I'm basically a little bit under a third of the way on Cartophila and a little bit under a third of the way on tarantulas. If I remember correctly, before I made the walk to go get the Cartophila, I had about like 80 tarantulas, I want to say. Maybe 90? So I'm getting maybe around like 100. I'm getting around 10 to 20 each time I walk, which is not bad at all. Alright, trade. Bam. Piles of cash. I will be putting an offer in for more of those. Again, I'm not 100% certain when I alt-tab out of the game whether or not my recording still goes, but I want to check something real quick, so if it's not recording, I apologize. I'm pretty sure it still picks up my voice at the very least. By the way, now I'm back in the game because I'm a little walking. Now I'm going back in. Let's see here. Okay, not quite yet. So, yeah, the other day I put a video up, the 10k quest one, the desert quest, and in that one I was, you know, I hit 100 subscribers. I was actually at 103 at that point, but still, I was at 100 subscribers. And I'm all, like, impressed with myself, you know. It's like a milestone. And then at approximately the same time, and I referenced it in my last video, The Nightmares at Yalahar, which you can click over there, I'm over 100,000 minutes watched. So I'm, you know, impressed with myself for that, too. For obvious reasons. What is that, a piercing bolt? Yeah. Deposit all. And I will be having, like, another two or so milestones in the coming days. So I'm excited about those, too. I was just checking to see if I had hit one of them already. It's a slight annoying issue. Perfect. I wish I could, like, not have to cut through Banatois, whatever it's called. Anyway, it's a slight annoying issue in that, like, today is the 20th, alright? It's 5:51 p.m. on October 20th, and YouTube's, like, statistics so far are only up to October 17th. So, actually, when I had said, you know, I had hit that 100,000 minutes threshold, I'd actually hit that approximately maybe like 4 days before the 17th. So I'd actually hit that on the 12th. But because YouTube takes like a while to actually give me the information, so I've probably hit like the other threshold, and I'm just not aware of the fact. There we go. Okay. I saw the green hit, and I was like, oh man, did I get poisoned already? You're kidding me. But nope, it wasn't me getting poisoned. It was me punching the centipede for 1 damage. I'm not even going to bother wasting my spears on this, to be honest. That said, it appears as if I'm not regenerating. Which is annoying. Because now I'm going to need to go get food from somewhere. Alright, let's divert over to where there are crocs. Oh man, the idea of killing crocodiles right now, like, fills me with dread. Dread. Crocodiles are still a cool thing to task at the beginning, though. Because, like, at those first couple of levels, you can't really use good equipment. And unless you've got somebody, like, funding your power leveling, you're definitely not going to be able to, like, use anything worthwhile. So, I mean, like, you're going to be fighting junk monsters regardless up until a certain point. You might as well be hunting task monsters that are also junk. So crocodiles are good regardless. So I don't regret killing the crocs, but oh my god, do I hate killing the crocs. Alright, I'm thinking, though, that I'm probably not going to end up with enough fish from these swamp trolls to make this viable. Also, it's funny, I spent most of my last couple of videos on Sylvius, hunting apes, actually, for whatchamacallits. They're furs. I would get it eventually, I knew I would. But yeah, I was trying to get their furs. Seriously, poison me? You suck, dude. And because that was, like, mind-bogglingly boring, and I was using, like, not crystalline arrows, so I could afford to be a little bit wasteful. So wasteful I was. I wasn't picking up the, like, under, like, 20 amounts of gold, essentially, from the swamp trolls, unless they also dropped something else that I wanted. Not swamp trolls, I'm sorry, the apes. So I was, like, really only looting maybe, like, half of all of the apes that I was killing. Well, that was a good little bit of lag there. Give me my fish. Alright, you know, these stupid rats. Alright, I guess we're good. I'm just gonna leave that on the floor, to be honest. Okay, I'm gonna kill the slime and then off we go. That's probably a wholly insufficient amount of food that I'm bringing with me, but whatever. It'd be actually kind of cool if I could break a spear right now. Just so that I could, Oh, no, 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 you're not getting away from me. There you go. You're not getting away from me, even if I have to cheat. Yeah, I would be kind of okay with breaking a spear right about now. Of course, it's not gonna happen. We'll wait until I get to the place, and then I'll break all of my spears at once. That's how it usually goes. Ugh, Jesus. Seriously, like, does the people in my house not know how to speak without screaming? Like, come on. And, like, does this door need to be slammed every single time? Come on, people. You're killing me. Still talking. Still just standing out in front of my window, screaming into the house. I'd like, again, I'm like, I said this before. I'm trying to be, like, really understanding of the situation, because it's a difficult situation. Don't get me wrong. You know, and, like, I wouldn't wish this on anybody. Even if I have a certain amount of glee where I'm like, ha ha ha, being a terrible person has caught up to you. Like, feel the consequences for sucking. You've sucked for years, and now you're dealing with the consequences. Like, I do have a little bit of, like, almost like an I told you so sense. I mean, it's not really I told you so, because, like, I didn't actually tell her anything, but, like, I just have a, you know, like, it's almost in that sense where, like, every day you're like, you know, you should really be riding your motorcycle with a helmet. You should really be riding your motorcycle with a helmet. You should really be riding your motorcycle with a helmet. And the person, like, smashes into a wall and, like, you know, splits their skull open or something like that. You're like, well, you knew you weren't supposed to be doing that. And I have to say, I'm a little bit like, huh, yeah, you know? You kind of deserve that. That's how I am right now. Just kind of like, you know, you kind of deserve this. But, I mean, like I said, I do feel for the problem and like, you know, I feel bad and I'm trying to be like really considerate and everything like that and not make like a big stink about everything that's happening. But like, dude, come on, work with me. Can you die a little bit faster, Mr. Carnifella? Alright, we hit you, there we go. I hate going through the jungles of Port Hope to Quanda. Port Hope is the town, to Quanda is the jungle. Actually, I think Taquanda is the, like, side of the continent. I think they're the jungles of Taquanda, is how it works. I'm also trying not to get into Benatoa. Because I don't want to kill apes, for starters, because I hate apes. For two, I hate killing task monsters when I'm not on the task. It hurts my soul. Alright, you die, Mr. Congra? You die. You die. You die better. Thank you, Mr. Conger. Take the bananas, too, while I'm at it. Alright, that's probably not enough food. We're just gonna roll with it. Whatever. So anyway. Normally, I don't do leaf videos as frequently as I did. Although, to be fair, this one's probably not gonna go up for, like, a while, so it's fine. Still, point is, normally I don't do leaf videos, but I did actually want to talk about things. So, like, a couple Leaf videos ago, I kind of, like, mentioned my job and how, you know, I started this new job and it sucks. I did actually kind of want to, like, return to that. While I don't want to just spend my time complaining about my job, I do actually just want to talk about the job and jobs in general. Whoop, that's a Carnifella. Whoop. Oh, my God. The jungles of Port Hope. Thank you. I'll just keep myself paralyzed, it's cool. I don't actually want the Carnifella to not hit me. I would like everything to keep being in my way. Thanks. Thanks, game. I really hate this jungle. Alright. So now that sucked. At least the Carnifella helped thin out some of the stupidity that's around me. Ugh. Also, why am I sufficiently farther south than I meant to be? Alright, let's kill these things so they don't get in my way. Let's fail to kill these things. I suppose that's just as good. I hate using spears. Oh my god, I can't wait until I have the money to not be using spears. Kill the crap. Did I get poisoned again? How did I get poisoned? I don't even care. You know, I don't care. Who cares how I got poisoned? Anyway. So, the first thing I want to kind of talk about is, like, you know, I was complaining about that manager. What I've realized is that he's just really socially awkward. Like, really, really, really socially awkward. Which, I mean, like, it's cool. Like, I guess, it's nice to know that he doesn't hate me, because, like, that was kind of a concern I had. Because he did treat me like I was an idiot all the time, and that was kind of annoying. But yeah, he is just, like, socially awkward. Like, since then, we've been able to make some small talk. I also think he's not a very good, like, morning person, and, you know, I work third shift, and I see him when he's coming in at 5 a.m. So I think he's just, like, out of his element at that point. Still, that's not really a good excuse for, like, you know, making your employees uncomfortable. And, like, there's a reason why I'm being paid $8 an hour, and he's probably being paid something closer to, like, $20 or $30 an hour. So, like, it's his job to make me not feel uncomfortable and everything. But, like, again, you know, whatever. Whoa, there's usually not a mutated human down here. That's kind of annoying. It's probably gonna... There we go, I got poisoned. That's annoying. For sure, that's annoying. Put my creature products in the bag. And eat some bananas. There we go. So yeah, though, like, he offered me a ride home one day and stuff like that. So he's not, like, actually a terrible dude. He's just weird. I don't know. So, I mean, like, there's that. The one thing I want to say, though, about this gas station is, like, so we don't hire minors. You have to be, like, 18 or older to work at this gas station. And I think that's... part of the reason... So, like, so far since I've been working there, we've lost, like, five people or something like that. Out of a crew of, like, 15. So we just keep getting new people and, like, losing people and stuff like that. Like, it's actually kind of a problem. And I think it's not because we don't hire minors, like, precisely, but that's, like, a symptom, sort of. So here's the thing, right? We don't hire minors. Which means we're all adults, and we're kind of expected to act like adults. Now, for anybody who hasn't worked what I call, like, minimum wage retail, which is, like, you know, Walmart, gas stations, things like that. I look leveled up. If you haven't worked minimum wage retail, you're not going to really know exactly what I'm talking about. But, and like, you know, Costco or some other company that doesn't pay you a crap rate isn't the same thing. But when you're working minimum wage retail, you're basically just like a body. You know, like anybody can do the minimum wage retail. Like, you do not need to know. Really, you can basically work, like, I've worked with a guy who ran cash register at that grocery store I used to work at, who didn't know how to read. So, like, you can definitely just work minimum wage retail and, be absolutely stupid. You know, he was, like, a nice guy, sort of, and everything, but, like, yeah, he didn't know how to read, and I doubt he knew, like, basic math skills either. Okay. This is why this place is scary, by the way. okay, keep up the heals. Keep up the heals. Out of mana. No! Oh my god, I don't even know what just happened there. I accidentally clicked on the screen, I think. Alright, well, that was a disaster. For sure, that was a disaster. Alright, I want to loot my bodies. Aw, yeah, looting bodies. My favorite thing. Gotta remember to put my shield back on, by the way. Alright, am I poisoned currently? How badly am I poisoned? Okay, I'm poisoned enough that I'm gonna Xanapox it. Wow, terrible loot, by the way. God, she's so loud over there. You know, I was planning on going down again, but I did not bring enough flame arrows, so that's not happening now. But, anyway. So, like, when people apply for, you know, minimum wage retail, they kind of know what's expected of them. And also, like, those businesses treat their employees as, like, disposable resources. Like coal, like an oil well or something like that. To be used until it runs out and then move on to another one. Like, businesses that hire for minimum wage retail are, like, swarms of locusts. They're not looking for, like, sustainable. This gas station I'm working at and that grocery store I was working at was not looking for permanent employees. If they got a permanent employee, that's, like, fine and dandy. I don't think they actively disliked permanent employees, because permanent employees are definitely better than new hires, but on the other hand, you know, we have to get paid a little bit more. The thing is that to, like, train a new employee takes, like, I don't know, 5 days or something like that. Like, very minimum effort to get a new employee on one of those jobs. So what they do is they pay us nothing. They, like, demand a whole bunch of, like, you know, demanding stuff. And then eventually we're like, oh, well, I hate this, I'm done. And then they just repeat the process. They, like, they're okay with running us ragged because they know we're replaceable. And we're easily replaceable. And I'm not trying to, like, harp on the businesses, because, like, that's just their business model. And you need to know that if you're getting into a job like that. Like, just be aware of what you're getting into, is what I'm trying to say. anyway, the problem with the gas station I'm working at is we don't hire minors, which means we're all adults, and under that assumption, it's reasonable to ask more of us. The problem is that they don't pay us more. We're still being paid minimum wage retail. So people get hired for this job thinking it's normal minimum wage retail, where it's like a whole bunch of kids, where you're basically being hired to just stand there in front of the cash register and frown. Then they actually get into the store and they're like, oh wow, like they're actually demanding things of us. So it's partially like people go in with incorrect expectations, and then also like the amount of work that they're paying us for is not fair. Like, for sure, I'm doing way more work at this gas station, and so is everybody else at this gas station, than I ever did at that grocery store, and I'm being paid the same price. So just on that, I don't think they're paying us a competitive rate for like what we're doing. But the bigger issue is that people go in with expectations of like, oh, I'll just have to do nothing. And then you get in there and you're like, oh, wow, I'm definitely they're asking me to do a lot more than I was expecting. So that's why we keep losing people. Which is a shame, but we're also like a corporation. We're not like a franchise. Which I also feel like is bad because like corporations are perfectly fine when they're perfectly fine, but they also can be absolutely horrible. There's like a phrase like the left hand doesn't know what the right hand is doing kind of phrase. I'm sure you've probably heard that before. And that usually sums up corporations. I'm not sure. Like, corporations always have these policies for their workers that, like, are completely idiotic and that, in theory, like, nobody does, but they act like everybody does. I'm never sure, is the corporation aware that nobody's doing that and that everybody's like, oh my god, this is stupid? And they're just saying to do it anyway? Or is the corporation actually, like, thinking that everybody is doing it and being like, yeah, go team, we're working correctly. It was awesome how I just missed that a million times, by the way. Like, I wonder about that sometimes. Because I'm sure, like, most people who have... I don't really want to let him hit me. I don't know how strong he is, but he scares me. Like, you know, when they're like, oh, I need you to clean this thing, like, 4 times a day. We were like, okay, I mean, like, maybe for sure that's something that actually needs to be cleaned 4 times a day, and there's definitely things that should be cleaned 4 times a day. Message him at some point. Although it was 6 minutes ago. That's a shame. I did not notice it. Sorry, Goldcut. I will message you after my video is over, and hopefully you're still on. Are you still on? That's not the, is he... Oh, nope, he logged off. I'm sorry, Gold Kite. My apologies. But yeah, so, like, I don't know. They just have, like, there's always these policies where they're like, you know, I need you to do this. And I wonder if they're saying that for, like, almost liability. So, like, they're like, okay, make sure you do A, B, and C. And they're saying that knowing that you're not going to do A, B, and C. But if something goes wrong, then they can be like, well, it's not our fault. It's the employee that didn't do A, B, and C, so we can fire that guy. Because that's kind of how I usually feel it works. Like, actually, and the reason why I brought this up is because I actually want to talk about a couple of things. So, the last, like, 2 nights, though, at my gas station have just been absolutely abysmal for me. There we go. And I did not realize I was running into a rock there, just for the record. And did I just let that carnophila poison me again? Ugh, Jesus. So, like, I like when I can't drink the potion because I'm paralyzed. And then I keep failing to, like, move, and then need to drink the potion even harder. But anyway. So the first night, right, I come in at 10. That's my shift. I work 10 to 6 a.m. Come in at 10, and the dude that's there, he's, like, on his way out. He has to wait for me to get in. And then, he's the only employee currently in the store. And then when I come in, I become the only employee currently in the store. So he's, like, on his way out. He's like, oh, by the way, like, a little while ago, a dude came in the bathroom and he smelled kind of weird, so you might want to check on that. I'm like, oh, man. Like... If some dude, like, explosive diarrhea all over my floor or something like that, I'm gonna be upset. Like, I'm gonna legitimately be furious if I have to deal with poop all over my bathroom floor. Or, like, he pooped in the sink or something like that, or he vomited. Like, he didn't really elaborate on what, like, smells weird means. So, I mean, like, I don't know what's happening. But I'm like, dude, like, you gotta be kidding me. So I quick, like, I go into the bathroom, So the way it works is, like, we have a hallway, right, and there's 2 separate doors, one for the men's and one for the women's. And the men's bathroom has, like, a sink, a trash can, and, like, a slightly open area, and then also a urinal with, like, a wall around it a little bit, but no door. And then a stall, and it's a big stall that's, like, handicap accessible. And from, like, when you open up the door and you look at the stall door, the toilet is behind the actual stall wall. So from, like, if the door is open, you can't see the toilet unless you walk further into the bathroom, okay? So I walk in and I see that the door is shut. The stall door is shut. So I'm like, all right, somebody's using the bathroom currently. I'll come back. So I leave. I figure I'll go check later on. It's busy at this point. Usually I get most of my... I get pretty much all of my customers from, like, 10 to 12, and then I get a burst of customers at around 5 to 6 when, like, the morning rush is starting. But anyway. So I'm like, all right, you know, let's do this. So it's busy. I can't get into the bathroom. It just kind of, like, slips my mind. So at midnight, a customer comes in. He's like a common regular customer. Everybody knows him. So I'm like, oh, hey. He's like, yeah, I gotta use the bathroom. I'm like, all right. Hopefully this doesn't kill me, by the way. I'm gonna stop talking until I kill these two. Because I don't want to just keep running sideways. More of them, like that, for instance. Way to miss. Way to keep missing. There we go. And then I pulled another one on me anyway. Yeah, see, this is exactly what I'm terrified of. Oh, look, I got another one. Now I've got three on me. And I'm just... Yeah, there we go. Thank you. I was just, like, not killing them. Just not killing them. And last one. Ooh, I got a corn cob. It'd be awesome if I managed to loot a carrot on the stick, by the way. Just throwing that out there. Alright. So. Looted my bodies. So he comes in, he's like, yo, I gotta pee. I'm like, alright. You know where the bathroom is, right? He's like, yeah. So he goes, and then he comes back, and he's like, yeah, somebody's in there. I'm like, ah, man, really? And one of the things I thought when I checked the door was maybe it's not a customer, maybe, like, a kid locked the door and slid out underneath it or something like that. Because that wouldn't be the first time that's ever happened. So I'm like, crap, you know? Like, this is not what I want to deal with right now. Mutated humans... Do. Man, I wish I had Utura at this point. Mutated humans are such good money, though. Such good money. By the way, the wishing for Utura had nothing to do with the fact that I'm fighting mutated humans. It was just like a, I wish I had Utura. You suck! That was an amazing, well-timed miss. Thank you, game. And also, me going, they have good money, also had nothing to do with the fact that I wished I had Uter. That was a really weird way of me saying things right then. Sorry. So anyway, like, I thought there was, like, maybe a kid locked it from the inside and then slid out. Because, again, like, that's a thing that can happen. So he's like, oh, yeah, it's locked. And I'm like, oh, man, do I have to slide underneath it myself? That's gonna suck. Like, I've cleaned that bathroom floor, and I definitely have seen people pee on my floor. Like, I do not want to touch the floor and have to slide underneath a really tiny doorway. But he's like, yeah, I think somebody might be in there. So I'm like, all right, well, would you mind going to check to see if somebody's in there? He's like, no, not at all. So he comes back. He's like, yeah, I looked underneath it. I saw, like, a pair of feet in sandals. Like, all right. So there's a person in there. And at the time, I had the delivery truck delivering, a new load of gas. So we're both like, maybe it's the delivery guy from the gas truck. We're like, alright. And he's like, dude, it's, like, super cold, though. And we had, like, a cold snap, basically, move in. So it was, like, 25 degrees Fahrenheit, which would be, like, -5 Celsius or something like that. it was super cold and not the kind of weather you'd want to be walking around in sandals in, for sure. So we're both like, you know, this is kind of strange. So we wait like 10 minutes, you know, the customer like, you know, buys his stuff and things like that. And then he's like, let me go check again. And he's like, yeah, the guy's still in there. So I'm like, all right, this is kind of annoying. I mean, you know, like normally if you're having like some kind of bathroom disaster, you shouldn't use a public restroom. Just, you know, but on the other hand, if you're about to have a bathroom disaster, feel free to use a public restroom as opposed to just going on my floor or going on like the side of the road or something like that. So, I mean, like, I'm not gonna get too upset about the guy and his bathroom disaster. So he's like, yo, can I use the women's bathroom? And I'm like, sure. So he goes in the women's bathroom, and then he comes back out, like, a second later, and he's like, yo, come here. So we both go into the women's bathroom. He's like, put your ear on the wall. So I put my ear on the wall, and all I hear from the wall is... I'm like, aw, dude, seriously? The guy's been sleeping in my bathroom? And then I'm thinking to myself, this is probably that guy that came in before that my coworker told me about. This is the dude that smells weird and that has been in my bathroom for now for at least 2.5 hours, sleeping in the only toilet in the men's bathroom. And I'm like, what am I supposed to do in this situation? Like, I do not want to wake up the dude who's sleeping in a public restroom. All right? I mean, like, hold on a second. I'm just checking my, my kills. Carnophila? 88. Okay. I'm trying to finish this, and I think I'll go kill Deathbind also in this video. So that's for, especially since I have the spears. Although I'm kind of running out of, inventory, which is a shame. Kill it better, please? Yeah, actually. Ugh. I'm gonna just throw the... I was gonna say I'm just gonna throw the money on the floor and then come back for it. I'm definitely still at the point where I'm poor enough that I can't just afford to, like, waste money. But if I throw the money on the floor, that's gonna make this video take a whole lot longer than I want this video to take. But I also want to finish. This sucks. Okay. Well, Carnophila don't drop. Jesus. Alright, yeah, we're just gonna be coming back in this video. Sorry. I'm gonna just throw the money on the floor. reason being, I'm gonna kill all those mutated humans on the way out, and they're definitely going to drop a whole bunch of gold that I'm definitely not gonna be able to carry. And I'm gonna pick up another backpack, soon and stop just carrying around a bag. I'll have a backpack full of gold. Anyway, so I'm like, dude, anybody that sleeps in the bathroom of a gas station has, like, something going wrong with them, right? Like, alright, folks, had to pause there. Killed a Carnophila. I don't think there was anything in it. What was it? Yeah, actually nothing inside it. There we go. Fine. I'm like, you know, anybody who's sleeping in the bathroom of a gas station is definitely got some kind of issue. Whether or not they're homeless... it's not like I live in an area that has high homeless. I do live in, like, the Philly suburbs, but I live far enough away from the Philly suburbs that there shouldn't be homeless people where I'm at. And also, I live where I work is in, like, a wealthier area, so there definitely should not be homeless people in that area. So, like, I don't know if he's homeless. I don't know if he's, like, wasted. I don't know if he's on drugs. But, like, none of those things are, I want to wake this dude up while I'm in the store by myself. So the customer was like, yo, like, I'm going to drive by the police station and I'll just send some cops over. So I'm like, all right, yeah, please do that. Because I don't want to wake him up. So a cop comes over. I, like, explain, I'm like, yeah, the dude's, like, in the bathroom. So he's like, all right. So the cop goes in the bathroom and then just, like, doesn't come out for 5 minutes. I'm like, this is weird. So then another cop pulls up. There we go. Backpack's filled. Another cop pulls up. I'm like, yeah, the other cop's in the bathroom. So he goes in the bathroom. So now these two cops and the sleeping dude are just in my bathroom for like 10 minutes, right? So then eventually, like, they get him out. The dude's all, like, groggy, so apparently he's, like, super tired or something like that. So now they're, like, standing by the exit door of my store. So, like, also every additional customer that comes in gets to be, like, a foot away from the two cops, plus the dude who smells weird and is being questioned by the cops, apparently. I didn't get close enough to him to actually confirm whether or not he smells weird, just for the record. I'm just relying on what my coworker said. The guy smells weird. So I'm like, you know, and then it's, like, the weirdest conversation. Like, I've been questioned by the cops, like, for minor things and not, like, a crime. Like, they've been like, what are you doing out here? And stuff like that. So, like, never an actual issue where they would be, like, writing up a report on me or anything along those lines. So, like, I don't know what the norm is for being questioned by the cops, but, like, this was the weirdest thing I've ever watched. So, for 30 minutes, they question this guy while he's in the store. He refused to look at the cops. He spent the entire time staring, like, at his feet, straight down at the ground, the entire time. Which was weird enough. ton of Phylla seeds. I do want to come back for that sling herb. And there we go. Backpack's filled. Alright, so I'm going to head out now. Resupply, come back. And then I guess maybe I'll do Deathbind at the beginning of the next video instead of this video. We'll see. I wish there was a way for me to tell how long the video is at this early stage, and there's not, which is unfortunate. I can see how big the video is in a file size, but that's it. Oh, that's cool. That was just standing next to me. At least they didn't get to, like, hit me. And then do its little poison exori. So, like, the dude, the whole time, though, he just refused to, like, look at the cops and just looked straight at the ground the entire time, which was definitely weird. And then they'd ask him a question, and he'd, like, mumble out an answer, and then they'd just stand in silence for a little while. Like, they wouldn't ask additional questions, he wouldn't say anything else, and he'd just look down, they'd look at him, 30 seconds, 45 seconds, a minute, 2 minutes, and then he'd be like, oh, yeah, I'm from Pittsburgh. And they'd be like, okay. And then, like, a long pause. And they'd be like, okay, so what are you doing here? And then there'd be this long pause. It was so strange. Apparently, from what I overheard, he's from Pittsburgh. For anybody who doesn't know, Pittsburgh's on the other side of Pennsylvania. It's on the, the west side. And then Philly's on the, like, southeast. Pittsburgh's on the southwest. I'm going up the stairs. All right. Gotta remember that there's a whole bunch of mutated humans right up here. So I don't just sprint up here like I did the last time. I got poisoned, though. Can I avoid getting poisoned again? Nope, I can't. I should have just left myself be poisoned until I killed them all. That was stupid on my end. Alright. Now I can cure my poison, though. Now somebody's gonna swoop in here and steal all my crap. I'm gonna be irritated, but whatever. There should be, one are up here somewhere, I think? Maybe? Okay. I was gonna say, I'm pretty sure there's more mutated humans. So the dude just is like... from what I gathered, he was in Pittsburgh. He won money on a lottery ticket. Now, I don't know if it was a scratch-off lottery ticket or, a daily number drawing lottery ticket or something like that. He won money on it, though. He hopped on a bus, came to Philly, because we have, there's, like... casinos here. I don't think there's casinos in Pittsburgh, but I know there's some casinos around the Philly area. So he came, went to the casinos, lost everything at the casinos that he, I guess, had. And then kept enough money to take a bus to some, like, random location, and then just got off at my gas station and decided to spend the night in my bathroom until, like, somebody could come and pick him up or something. I don't even know what his plan was. But it was the strangest thing. And I have the hiccups. So the cops, he asked if he could be taken to, like, a hospital. I'm thinking he was probably either, like, ultra drunk. Where is the car? There we go. He was either, like, ultra drunk. Oh, because I ate the ham. Alright, I was a little confused there. He had to have either been ultra drunk or, like, high. And I think that's why he was looking down, because he didn't want the cops to see his eyes. Who knows? But yeah, so, like... what's annoying about this situation is, while it was an interesting situation, for sure, and I enjoy the story it let me tell, but also, like, what was obnoxious is, at work, I'm still, like, in the stage of being, like, I'm not 100% certain what the most effective way is to do things. So, like, I'm kind of rushed, and I don't have, like, a good system yet. So anything that disrupts my system is just a disaster. And for the first 2 hours, it's still kind of too busy for me to, like, get off the register and start doing other things. And then also, for the first 2 hours, there's not a lot I can do. Like, the things that take me the most time to do are cleaning the coffee pots and, like, making new coffee and cleaning the grill. And neither of those things can be done until, like, late because, when I go to, like, make the coffee has to be fresh at around 4, so, like, the coffee has to be made at around 5. So I can't start working on the coffee at 10, or, like, 11, or something like that. And it's the same with the grill. The grill has to stay up until, like, 12 o'clock, 12, 1 o'clock. So, point is that at around 12, 1 o'clock is when I start doing things. And then at around 12, 1 o'clock is when I found out there was a dude sleeping in my bathroom and I had to, like, talk to cops, and then I had cops there and I didn't want to, like, just leave the cops unattended and things like that. So I stayed at the register the whole time that the cops were there. So it just put me massively behind, which was obnoxious. So that was, yeah, that was two, wow. Wow. Getting, like, flanked by Carnophila here. I wonder if that counted as a kill. I wish I knew how many I had before I killed that one. Alright, do I have dark mushrooms already in my bag? I do, apparently. Good to know. And the centipede. So yeah, that was two nights ago. So last night I go in, right? Occasionally they give me another, like, coworker until, like, 12 or 11. I don't know why, and they do it, like, randomly. It's nice, but it's not very helpful, because I still can't do anything while I have that additional employee. Like, I can't start taking down, like, the grill or anything like that until, you know, 12, 1 o'clock. So having an employee only there until 12 kind of doesn't really help me as much as I would like it to. That said, I mean, it does give me, like, another human being to talk to and stuff like that, so, I mean, it's not terrible. I'm not gonna be like, you don't need to give me an employee. So anyway, she leaves, and she actually leaves, like, a little bit early, like, 5 minutes early. The way it works is, like, you're not supposed to, I mean, obviously it's different, at nighttime like that, but normally when you have, like, a relief person coming in, right? So, like, I work until 6, and then I've got a person coming in at 6 to relieve me, in other words. So normally in that situation, you have, I'm not content with that amount of poison. So yeah, normally in that situation, like, I just put the wrong amount of gold on the floor, it doesn't matter though. So I'm there until 6. I can't start, like, signing off my register until, that other person comes in, because we can't just have my register not operational. So that other person comes in at 6, and then I start doing the countdown on my register, which involves basically, like, just taking all the money out, counting it, and then, like, filling out a form, being like, you have this much money in your register. The register I'm on overnight has extra things that need to be done to it that the other registers don't, but it's not that big of a deal. But anyway, so, like, you can't start that until the other person comes in, and assuming that the other person is in on time, that means you can't start it until your shift is actually supposed to be over. So I'm scheduled until 6, but I can't start the process of leaving until exactly 6. And again, that's assuming that the person's on time. If the person's not on time, we've got a whole different situation. So anyway, point is, normally I don't actually get it. For the love of God, there we go. I don't actually start getting out until, like, 6. What I mean to say is, I don't normally leave the store and, like, clock out until approximately, like, 6:15 or something like that. So anyway, she leaves, like, a little early, and by that I mean, like, 10:55. So one of the things I always like to do is I like to check the schedule and see who I'm going to have, like, come in the morning. Because usually there's a food service person who comes in at 4, and then I have a manager come in at 5. And then I have, like, a relief person coming in at 6. And, like, I needed to talk to the main manager, who's not the weird one, about a couple of things. Like, I need to get a couple of days off and things like that. Anyway. And I like to know, like, who's the morning person I gotta deal with and stuff like that, because, you know, like, there's, not to be rude, but there's people that I'm more excited to work with than others. So, you know, it's whatever. It's whatever, guys. So I go into the, like, we have a really tiny office. It's like the size, the actual bathrooms are bigger than our manager's office, and that's where our schedule is and things like that. So I go in there, and while I'm in there, I hear this, like, beeping sound. And, the first thing that came to my mind was there's a case back there, like a metal cabinet that has an alarm on it because it's where we keep all the excess cigarettes. And that was what immediately came to my mind was that, because the night before, when I had to have the cops in, I was trying to restock the cigarettes, and I didn't have enough of the certain cigarettes out underneath the actual cigarette case, so I went into that, like, metal cabinet. And the bottom lock was, like, disengaged, but the top lock was still engaged, so I was, like, trying to pull it open, and then was realizing as I was, like, about to do that, that I might have set the alarm off. So my first thought was, like, oh, this alarm is going off. So then I get closer to it, and I'm like, wait, it's not coming from that corner, it's coming from a different corner. So on the other corner, there's these two blue boxes that are, like, I don't know what they do, but one of them said unleaded on it, which is a type of fuel. And that one's got, a really quiet alarm going off on it. And it says SU on it. So I'm like, okay, I don't know what that means. I'm not actually even sure what these boxes are for, right? Now, this is at, like, 11 now, right? A little bit before 11. Like, 10:55. So I'm like, okay, whatever. And, you know, it's busy, so I have a customer. So I go out, I wait on the customer, wait on another customer, wait on another customer. And then I'm like, all right, let me go check to see if I can figure out what that beeping is. So I go back in there. And now there's another thing beeping. And there's a big box that's called the Vita root. And that's the thing that, like, controls all of our gas flow and stuff like that. And that's got a flashing red light on it and is blaring a siren and going, like, gross line pump failure pressure leak. And I'm like, oh, God, I don't know what any of that means, but I'm freaking out, right? Can I just, like, kill that car and fill it? Thank you. I'm like, oh, man. So while I'm trying to figure that out, like, a whole bunch of customers come back in and are like, hey, I can't, like, pump. Nothing's coming out of the pump, but it doesn't say anything. I'm like, oh, great. So I definitely have, like, some kind of pump leak. So I have, like, no idea what I'm supposed to be doing, right? But all I remember from the training was the thing is called the Vita root again. And when they were, like, explaining the Vita root to me, they were like, this is the Vita root, and then that was the extent of the training on the Vita root, right? Like, there was nothing else, just this is the Vita root. And then the other thing they taught me about at the training was, like, a video that was probably produced before I was born about what to do in the event of, like, a gas spill. And it was like, we have three different classifications of gas spills. The first is a small spill, which means, like, you know, like, maybe somebody was filling up, like, a container of gas, and they dropped it on the floor, and there's, like, a puddle of gas. It's not growing, and it's not a huge spill. The other one is a large but contained spill, which is a large spill taking up a wider area that could still be growing, but, it's, like, something that I can, you know, throw down, like, blocking booms so that it doesn't flow elsewhere and kind of contain it myself. And also, like, we've got a cleaner that we can pour on it or spray on it that, like, breaks down the chemicals in the gas so that it's, like, biodegradable or some jazz like that. Of course, I don't know where that chemical is or anything along those lines. And then the other type of spill is a large uncontained spill. And a large uncontained spill is a spill that's going to or has already touched grass or anything else that could be considered nature, or it has touched the drains. So, in other words, like, as long as the spill is on our pavement, it's a contained spill. If the spill touches dirt or goes into the grass or flows into the road and goes into a storm drain, it's an uncontained spill. And if we have an uncontained spill, I have to call the fire department immediately, and then the fire department has to call the EPA, Environmental Protection Agency for non-Americans, and then it's just an automatic minimum $200,000 fine. And on top of that, like, you know, if there's a spill and, like, somebody's, like, gonna throw their cigarette on the floor or something like that, that's, you know, a problem. So I've got some kind of pressure leak that says gross line failure. I don't know what any of that means. My pumps are offline. I've got beeping alarms. So I'm like, holy crap, right? Like, this is really bad. So everybody was like, if something happens, call this one dude. So like, I grab my cell phone, I call the dude. He doesn't pick up. And I'm like, all right, maybe he doesn't recognize my number. So I call him with the store phone. He doesn't pick up. So I wait like 2 minutes. I call him again. He doesn't pick up. I wait two more minutes. I call him again. He doesn't pick up. So I text the other night crew guy, and I'm like, yo, can you give me the phone number of that dude we're supposed to call in case I'm calling the wrong number? He doesn't get back to me. So finally, I'm just like, screw it. I call the manager. The manager is like, okay, that's bad. I'm like, yes, I know. She's like, but I don't know what that means. I'm like, that's not making me feel confident. All right, let me, ooh, look at backpack. That's convenient. All right, let's go deposit all. All right. All right. Balance. Withdrawal. Oh, wow, I have a decent amount of money. I'm just going to withdraw 5,000 for now. Because I also need to get potions. And how many kills do I have to get for the Chronophila? 27. Bah. Alright. Mana pots? Mana. I'm gonna go with 25. That sounds like a good number. I need to get some of those flaming arrows. Let's go with a little bit more. There we go. 45 sounds good. And then I'll pick up some royal spears. Royal spears. 10 sounds fine. Alright, deposit the rest. And then I gotta dump all this crap on the floor. And by that I mean stick it in my depot. And do I have... Oh, I already had flaming arrows. Are you kidding me? Well, that's annoying. Oh, I also had food on me, too. That's also annoying. Alright, well, you know, that happens sometimes, I suppose. Right, I'm actually going to throw the bag on the floor. Yeah, we're just going to go back the way I literally just walked from. We'll go pick up all my stuff, finish the task, and then I'll come back, report to Grizzly Adams, and then end the video. And then the next video will start with me... killing Deathbind. On that note, though, I'm actually probably gonna have to pause the video here and, like, log out temporarily, because I'm about to have to do a stupid task. I want to finish my story first, though. Alright, folks, I actually have to go do that task now, so I'll finish my story later when I get back. I'm gonna just log out here and pause the recording. Actually, I'm gonna end the recording so I can see how long it's at. But anyway, I'll be back. Alright, I'm back. So I'm at 52 minutes so far, as anybody who's capable of looking at the YouTube video will know. But which I did not know, because my recording program does not tell me how long the video is while the video is still in the process of being made. So I want to try to make this quick. This will be one of the longer videos. I'm sorry, people. I still don't know if like longer videos are better or not. I try to do like a mix, basically, of both. Do some long ones, do some short ones. So whatever. Anyway, I totally kind of like don't remember where I was when I was talking. But I had to just go and move a giant refrigerator into my garage because. Let's just go with because. Anyway, I'm pretty confident I was still talking about the... see, like, alright, again, if I was making a video right now for, like, let's say Sylveus, like, hunting in Monster ABC, or something like that, or even if it was a quest, I probably at this point would have just scrapped the video, because taking a, like, 20-minute break in the middle of it is a problem. But, you know, Leaf is supposed to always be recorded, so I can't kill his videos and start over. Like, progress was made in this video that I can't redo. I leveled up, for instance. I have to just do what I can with this video after getting interrupted in, like, the stupidest manner possible. Oh, Jesus. You know, it's, like, cool living with people sometimes, but, like, when the people you live with suck, it's a lot better to just live by yourself. Anyway. So I call the, like, help desk people, right? That's where I think I was at. My manager told me to call the help desk. So I call the help desk. Meanwhile, I've got all these alarms off. Going off. I can't sell gas. And the pumps aren't, like, indicating that they can't, that they're not operational. So people are still able to, like, swipe their credit cards and put their, like, gas pump reward cards in, hoping to get, like, money off. And then it's, you know, just not working. Which is fantastic. So then all the people come in, like, confused. I have to, like, manually give them their money back. It's just a fiasco at this point, right? Then they're all angry at me because everybody that comes into our store is just, like, miserable. Like, just absolutely miserable. They're the just worst humans I think I've encountered. Whatever, though. Whatever. Don't care. Kill the spit metal. So, I was kind of hoping I could get some more meat from animals before I go in here. I'm going to actually have to buy some more brown mushrooms at some point. To just walk to Darashia to save money and then carpet to Darashia. It's funny because, like, just for a second there, I was thinking to myself about how, like, I don't want to buy them off the market for, like, 12 gold when I can buy them for 10. But considering how many of them I'm going to buy, and the fact that it's going to cost me how much to travel to Edron and then back, it's probably not worth it. I should probably just buy them off the market anyway. Well, it's whatever. Okay, so let me get my Kill the Cobra. So anyway, I call the help desk people. They leave me on hold forever first. And then, you know how, like, when you call tech support or something like that, right? They're, like, bored out of their mind, like, going through a script like a machine. Like, okay, did you plug it in? Okay, did you turn it on? Okay. You know what I'm talking about? So the lady I'm talking to at the help desk is, like, exactly that bored out of her mind. So we go through all the steps, and then she's like, okay, so what seems to be the problem? And I'm like, well, it says gross line failure, pressure leak. And she's like, whoa, okay, and, like, laughs nervously. And she's like, I'm going to have a technician call you immediately. Bye. I'm like, whoa, lady, that's not making me feel more confident. Now I'm, like, absolutely terrified. I'm like, dude, this place is paying me $8 an hour, and that $8 an hour is with me having 5 years of supervisor experience in a supermarket. Otherwise, I would have started at minimum wage, $8.25. I mean, like, I'm not going to complain about the $8 an hour or anything like that, but $8 an hour is definitely not enough for me to consider being exploded a viable, like, option at work, you know? I can call the cops and get a dude that's sleeping in my bathroom out without being too upset. I'm not dying in a fire explosion for this place. So I'm, like, super nervous, right? So I wait, like, 45 minutes. I have to keep running outside and telling people that they can't pump before they start pumping. Every time I try to do something in the store, I miss a customer pulling in, and then they come in and are complaining about the pump not working. Like, it's just an absolute disaster at this point. So finally, like, 10, 15 minutes later, the dude calls me. He's like, yeah, I tried to, like, reset your machine, like, wirelessly, and it's not working, so I'm gonna have to come in. I'm like, okay. He's like, but I gotta go to, like, another store all the way up in, like, Lancaster first. I'm like, all right. He's like, because, you know, it's, like, first come, first serve. I'm like, okay. Like, they have a problem similar? He's like, no, they're, one of their associates locked the front door, and then the manager went outside to smoke a cigarette through the emergency exit and shut it behind her. So, like, they're just locked out of their store. I'm like, yo, you know what? Like, I'm running the risk of fiery death, and I can't sell any kind of gas right now, even without the fiery death, because of my equipment, like, not working. You're telling me you're prioritizing a moron store that locked themselves out? Are you kidding me? I know it's first come, first serve, but, like, they deserve to be punished for their stupidity. And again, the worst thing that happens for them is that they don't spend any money. Me, I got fiery death explosions. So I'm like, well, how long do you think it'll be? He's like, oh, I don't know, probably like 3 hours. I'm like, oh my god. So like, I spend literally 3 hours there at work being like, oh my god, is it gonna explode and kill me? Oh my god, is it gonna explode and kill me? I can't get anything done. You know, 12 comes around, I can't do anything at 12. 1 o'clock comes around, I can't do anything at 1 o'clock. 2 o'clock comes around, I can't get anything done at 2 o'clock. I'm just like, I'm super far behind. I'm like stressed out. I can't like leave the front end because then I won't be able to see customers coming into the lot. So I'm like there on my phone, I'm like, YouTube, gas station explosion. Like, I watched the first video, and it's like a dude crashes into one of the pumps and then it like lights his car on fire. And I'm like, oh, that's not too bad. I'm like, wait, though, this isn't a problem with my pumps. Like, it's a problem with my main like storage tanks. So I'm like, gas station tank explosion. And like, I get this video from Russia where like the entire gas station just explodes into a giant fireball. And I'm like, oh, man. So I'm like, I'm super nervous and everything like that. And just like incredibly unhappy. Then the dude comes in, and it was like, before the dude gets in, I'm like getting annoyed that I don't know what those like alerts say. So like, I Google the first one that says like gross line failure, and I get the like instruction manual for the machine, the Vita root, but like, I can't really understand what it's saying, and all of the alerts can mean like one of 4 or 5 different things, so it's not really helping me. So then I search out the thing that was saying SU, because I wanted to know what that meant. So SU means, like, it's an electrical short circuit, which is, like, freaking me out even more. Because, like, if I just have a leak, like, you know, remember I said we had that, like, cold snap? I'm thinking, like, maybe something froze and cracked or something along those lines, like a valve froze and then expanded or something along those lines. You know, if that happens... And I had to keep going out to check and make sure we weren't, like, leaking gas onto the road. So, like, alright, we're not leaking gas outside, so that means we're probably leaking gas internally. Which, like, isn't great, but as long as I can't smell the gas smell, like, I know I don't have a problem on that end. And with the pumps offline, like, it's unlikely that it will actually explode, mostly. But now I've got, like, a short circuit, and who knows what the short circuit's doing. The short circuit could be, like, pumping gas into something accidentally. It could be sparking. Who knows what's happening? So then I start getting nervous again. So anyway, the dude comes in. He's like, oh, yeah, this machine just isn't, like, high quality. It's just, like, not working. Just hit the reset button. And then he fixes it. I'm like, dude, are you kidding me? So, yeah, though, I was all, like, super behind. We had to pay to get, like, a maintenance dude out, which my managers weren't happy about. But again, like, there was literally no way I could fix that. So it's, like, definitely not my fault. But yeah, it was like just mad terrifying the whole night. I was absolutely miserable. I was just like, dude, I hate this job. Like, I really hate this job. Like, the work sucks, the pay sucks. I spent 3 hours of my life being like legitimately afraid I was going to die in an explosion. It's just, yeah, like, I hate this job. Like, I really hate this job. Oop, a little bit of lag there. We keep losing employees, like, they, you know, they quit. Like, it just, it's not looking like a good place to be. God, I, like, hate the freaking jungles of Taekwondo. Now I'm somehow stuck over here in this dead end, which is great. My spears are just absolutely crap. Can we, okay, good thing I killed that tarantula. Spears, man. Spears. Alright, how do I get over there? Stop auto-walking towards the Carnifilla. Oh, jeez. So yeah, that was that. Now, the plan here was, after telling you those two stories, I was going to, because those are my two, like, most notable gas station stories now. I wanted to branch off and explain some stories from back when I worked at the grocery store, because I have a whole bunch of fun stories, but I don't have the time for it here, so we're just going to kind of work our way through this. Next Leaf video, I'll be talking about that, I suppose. Also, after this, my plan is to hop on FDR and make an FDR video talking about minimum wage, in case anybody's interested. Um, But yeah. On a side note, it got all, like, super cold the other day, right? And I was actually, like, it was unexpected and, like, really, really cold. But, you know, like, I love the cold and whatnot. And now after that's gone, it's, like, 70 degrees out right now. Fahrenheit. I don't know what it is in Celsius. I'm sorry, people. I can't give you Celsius temperatures. My stupid American brain doesn't allow me to do that. I apologize. Alright, let's see. Should have a couple more mutated humans. I'm sincerely hoping I'm not about to need to pause while I'm fighting a mutated human. Nope, looks like I'm good. See, like, some of the people, right, that know I'm recording, when I'm recording, will open up my door and then stare at me. Which is the, like, I need to speak to you. So then I will be like, okay, let me pause real quick. I'll kill the monster I'm currently fighting and then I'll pause. Other people will just start yelling my name before they open up my door and then fling my door open and just start, like, talking about whatever it is they're talking about. Which is super annoying. So whenever I hear, like, people moving in the hallway, I just need to be like, pause. Pause. Pause now. If I don't pause now, they're gonna ruin my recording. That's what happened in my one recording, actually. Wow. Boatloads of cash right now. Also, annoying that there's a Chronophila right there. Potion drink. Potion drink. Oh, really? Somebody's here? Are you kidding me? I'm totally just gonna hunt on top of them because screw them. Yeah, like for sure. Screw them. I'm gonna take the lump of earth though because I think that's worth something. Dude, are you kidding me? And they, like, massacred everything. What are they, like, a high level? You know, if I didn't have to move that stupid refrigerator, I would have been able to finish this. Oh, God. 14 of them? I am so massively irritated right now. Oh, God. See, like, this is what I get for being a nice person. I constantly think that. I'm like, wow, I'm a nice person. I should, like, I do nice things for people. And then people treat me like crap, walk all over me, and then I have to deal with this stupid kind of crap. The scary thing is, like, especially if this was on Olympa, I would definitely just hunt on top of this person. Because it's non-PvP. But, like, I have no idea how angry this person's just gonna randomly be, and they could just try to kill me. Pretty sure Leaf has blessings, so I won't lose anything, but still. But still. This is annoying. I'm so irritated right now. So irritated right now. It's not even funny. I just needed 14. Oh, I mean, for real, though. I didn't have to stop my recording to go get a freaking refrigerator into my garage. This wouldn't be a problem. And, like, right now, there's just an entire house's worth of stuff in my yard. I hope it rains. I so hope it rains. I so hope it rains. I don't want to go up here. I want Chronophila, not mutated humans. There we go. Alright, there's one. Oh, God. I'm so irritated right now by this situation. Oh, God. You know, and, like, the other annoying thing is that, like, you know, when I'm like, yo, excuse me, can you, like, do me a favor? You know, I'll be like, yo, can you do me a favor? All right, when's good for you? Like, can you do it now? Okay, I mean, like, well, I just need it, I need it done by Thursday. Can you get it done by Thursday, you know? Like, I'm asking you the favor. I'm trying to be considerate of whatever your situation is. Whereas, like, my family's like, yo, can you stop what you're doing right now? Because I need you to go move my giant refrigerator. I'm like, maybe I'm doing things. Maybe I'm playing an online game and making a recording at the same time and can't afford, or it's hugely inconvenient for me to just stop doing that. Level 40 Royal Paladin. Yeah, I'm totally just hunting on top of this guy. I really don't care. He's definitely not a bot, which is a shame. Now, I feel bad, but I'm definitely just hunting on top of him. I'm just finishing my task. Oh, God, and somebody in the other room left the phone off the hook. On that note, does he have, like, the full summoner's outfit? I think he had the full summoner's outfit. Yeah, that looks like the full summoner outfit. So, you know what? I don't know if he's actually a bot. He's probably not a bot at the moment, but he probably has a bot character that allowed him to fund that massive amount of money into his level 40 Royal Paladin. That or he, like, purchased gold or something like that. Regardless, I feel like there's a high probability that that dude's a scumbag, so I'm a lot less concerned about hunting on top of him than I would have been otherwise. Oh, come on. I'm not doing this. Alright, how many more do I have to get after this? Wow, it would be cool if I could hit this one. There we go. Oh, 58. Thanks, game. 70. 19. We're getting better. Maybe I'll kill this Carnophila tomorrow. I probably should have just killed it with spells. I'll play a Paladin Mage. Since the spears are so absolutely useless, I'll just deal all of my damage through magic attacks. Alright, how many more do I need? Killing in the name of Carnophila. Three more. Alright, I can probably just get the three more on the way out, so I'm just gonna leave. That, though, for real, sucked. For real, that sucked. Alright. Can I kill you, please, sir? That hit me. Are you kidding me? At least it doesn't poison me. Mutated flesh. Mm-mm, good. I love me some mutated flesh. Boop, 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 boop. Those are worth nothing. Those are absolutely worth nothing, by the way. They have, like, a rare chance of turning into plate armor. And, I think, like, a semi-rare chance of turning to brass armor, and then everything else that they can turn into is junk. Considering the flasks of rust removers, I think, are around, like, 50 to 75 GP, you're almost certainly gonna lose money on those pretty much consistently. Alright. I just need to kill three Carnophila on the way back. Deathbind will be at the beginning of next video. Hopefully I'll get something cool. That Paladin being there kind of ruined my life. For sure, that ruined my life. Should be some... Yep, there we go. There's one. I don't know, has anybody tried fighting the new Carnophilas, the, like, Omnivores, I think they're called? I did fiddle with them on the quest server. On the test server. They're basically just, like, much stronger Carnophila that I think are a lot faster. Oh, is he leaving now? No, he's just stealing my kills, though, which is cool. Dude. Yeah, I mean, like, die in a hole. Die in a hole. So help me God, if he comes down here and, like, kills all the remaining Carnophila, and then I can't get my 150th one. Alright, you know, to be fair, like, maybe that dude is just the normal playing richest level 40 I've ever encountered. And is able to buy the male summoner's outfit. It's funny, though, because, like, Sylvius is trying to get the male summoner's outfit right now, and I know exactly how expensive that's going to be. I'm actually, when I get back into town, I'm going to price check some of the stuff on the male summoners, because I want to know how much that dude spent. Because there's no way he hunted the giant spiders. Now, maybe he hunted the giant spiders on his level, like, whatever character or something along those lines. That's a possibility. But I want to see what ape furs are on the server. And also, now I'm going to regret my inability to... Oh, God, I hate the jungle so much. Just piles of crap everywhere. I wish I had, like, Divine Caldera right now. Just blow them all up. See, the cool thing about this is, like, it's definitely designed to be annoying. Like, nobody was like, oh man, like, Port Hope would be a lot cooler if it had a whole bunch of under 10 experience monsters flying left and right. Snakes? Yeah, let's put some snakes. Skunks? Bats all over the place? Spiders? Yeah. Like, nobody was like, this would make this place better. They were definitely like, wouldn't it be cool if, like, the jungle was alive with stupid things? That's probably actually what they thought. They would make the jungle look like it was alive, and then they just made it annoying instead. Sometimes Sipsoft definitely, like, botches it. The funny thing is, by the way, that I made that, like, hunting with bots video. Just on a side note, like, all the hunting with bots videos I make, I post them up on, like, Olympa has a, like, report a botter forum post, so, like, I post them all up there, which usually gets them a whole bunch of views. Teehee. So the first dude, like, Proslek or whatever his name was, he, like, tried to defend himself by claiming he wasn't a bot and calling me, like, a noob for, a kill. He's like, oh, so, like, ignoring a noob who's trying to steal my kills makes me a bot. And then he, like, made fun of my YouTube channel. So, like, screw that dude. But my most recent one with the botting with Hartingo, who also was clearly a bot. Also, just throwing out Hartingo, by the way, for anybody who didn't watch that one. He also died, like, 20 levels prior to a vampire. So he's definitely been botting vampires for, like, an extended period of time, like a scumbag. Anyway, some dude, like, posted a bajillion times on that video, like, commenting, being like, you don't know what you're talking about, you... Actually, I mean, if you just go to that video, like, hunting with bots, Hartingo or something like that, you'll see it, but the dude was definitely, like, calling me out for not knowing how the bots work and being like, you shouldn't accuse people unless you know what you're talking about. Dude, I don't know if it's you that own Hartingo and we're botting. I feel like there's probably a good chance that it is you. If it's not you that's botting and you're not Hartingo, then you're Hartingo's friend or you're somebody else that, like, is involved in the manufacturing of that bot or something like that. Because there's no way that dude wasn't a bot. Oh, boy. I just want to get back. I have to get ready for work soon. My limited amount of time to, like, do things that were enjoyable got involved in moving a refrigerator. An injured Carnophila? You would be hilarious if this is Carnophila's injured because it killed that paladin. That annoying paladin that's probably a cheating scumbag in some way. Again, to be fair, like, he might not be a cheating scumbag. He's just probably a cheating scumbag. You know, I don't want to be, like, unfair and whatnot, but... odds are he's probably a cheating scumbag. Because, you know what? Even if he did, like... even if he's got, like, a level 300 account... well, first of all, if he's got, like, a level 300 account, he's probably a bot just based off of that. But anyway... assuming that he actually, like, legitimately has a high-level character, and he was able to, like, fund his other, his level 40 paladin's character that he's tasking Carnophilos with, and he managed to get the summoner's outfit, including the cape and everything, he's still probably a bot, or, like, he purchased the money, because anybody that's capable of, like, getting that amount of money wouldn't waste it on something like that. Like, if you're wasting your money like that, that's because you didn't work hard to earn it in the first place. I mean, sure, it's, like, possible. Like, it's totally possible. I'm not buying it. Not buying it. Definitely think that guy cheated somehow to get his money. Alright, I am going to double check and make sure I've killed 150 Conophila after I kill the Spit Nettle. Or while I'm killing the Spit Nettle. Hopefully I don't die. Alright, good. We're good on Conophila. Actually, on that note, though, how am I on tarantulas? Oh my god. Back on the phone. Now being loud in the room again. This is basically what we do every night. Just for the record, we just, like, call everybody on our contact list and complain. It's not my fault. It's everybody else's. I'm the victim. It's killing me a little bit. So incredibly loud. And then we complain about things that don't even make sense. Like... we're like, wow, that guy's terrible because he, like, has shoes. Like, what? Like, that's where we're at this point, by the way. We're, like, we're bad-mouthing people because of, like, reasons that don't even make sense anymore. We've moved beyond the real reasons, and now we're moving into, like, nonsense reasons. On a side note, though, I appreciate that I can have this conversation, like, by just not giving any kind of, like, coherent detail, so we're not sure what we're talking about. So if I'm being overheard, it's still fine. It's whatever. I'm just, like, super irritated right now. Like, my video kind of fell apart here at the end because I had to split it. And then I'm going to have to go through the annoyance of, like, splicing it, which, like, actually doubles the length of the video, sort of. That's actually not what I meant to say. What I meant to say was, like, if I have two videos that are both, like, 3 gigs, and then I need to splice them together into one video, I'm left with the two halves, and then also the final video, which gives me a final, like, file size of 6 gigs, because I now have a total of 3 videos. And since my hard drive is relatively small, and I don't have a lot of, like, open space on it, that's a problem. So this whole thing just is, like, a hassle for me, and I wish it wasn't. And I still want to go price check those things, too. And, I gotta put in offers for the whatchamacallit, the trophies. So I actually still have, like, a decent amount of stuff to do, too. You know, oh my god, it's getting louder. Oh my god. I can't do this. Like, I just can't do this. Oh, Jesus. Like, a little bit of consideration, people. Just a little bit of consideration is all I'm asking for. And I'm definitely not getting it. Definitely not getting it. Oh, look at that. I leveled up. I've actually did that. Silvius did that when he... And he... The most annoying part was he leveled up from 49 to 50 when he did that. I'm just going to put it to the center. I wanted to pick up, like, I had 2 tasks to report, and I wanted to pick the 2 up before I hit 50. That way I could carry over points. Yeah, there's that dude. Stupid bot. Again, he might not be a bot, but he's definitely a scumbag in some way. Anyway, alright, let's see. Trophies. Trophy, I don't want. I want Cyclops trophies. Wow, are those people, like, smoking crack? What's going on there? Minotaur trophies. Oh, I can get nice rates on the miners. There we go. I'm gonna check my apples. Bag of apple slices. Somebody outbid me on that one. Awesome. 3, 1, 2, 3. Up yours, dude. Cancel that one. Alright, let's see here. And she's just, like, walking back and forth right now, so it's getting closer to my door, so I'm not even being protected by walls anymore. Anyway, I want to see spool. Spool of yarns are 100k minimum there. Let's see, how much are silks? You could just use 10 silks, for instance. They're 8k a pop. Sulfurs? How much are the magic sulfurs? Not tracking. Magic sulfurs. They're not bad. 8k. That's not terrible. I think you can sell them to an NPC for 8k. So that's a reasonable right price. Ape furs. How much are those? Yeah, 9k an item. So, I mean, like, that dude's outfit cost an enormous amount of money. So, yeah, I'm pretty confident he's a cheating scumbag. I hope he dies. And look, he just bought it and made a whole bunch of arrows or a whole bunch of bolts and let them fall on the floor. Well, now if I grab a crossbow, I can use those for a while. Anyway, people, I'm going to just log out here when I get to the trainers. But, yeah, people, so I apologize for this. This video kind of fell apart here at the end. Whatever. So anyway, I'd like to thank everybody again, though. Thank you for giving me 100 subscribers, and thank you for giving me 100,000 minutes of watch. And you should like, favorite, comment, and subscribe. And I don't really use the Facebook anymore, but you can check me out there. I post all my videos on Twitter, so you can get them there. You can also check them out on Patreon. Sometimes I post them early on Patreon, so you can check them out on Patreon. I might also start posting them early on Twitter, but I think for now I'm just going to leave it early on Patreon. So you can check me out on Patreon. And folks, I'm going to end my video here.